In this lesson, we will cover how to use the out-of-the-box project templates that the Layer team has created for you. You can explore all of them on our website under the section Templates. There, you can see the main attributes of each template and what it does. You can also preview a template before using it on any project. Project templates can be leveraged when starting a new project as well as when wanting to combine different workflows within a project. Towards the end of the video, I will create my own template that can be used anytime I want to start a new project or update an existing one. The first time that we leverage project templates is when we start a new project. In lesson 1, we started a project from scratch, but this time we will apply a template to get started. Since I am working on my interior's residential project, I will choose the FFNE template. The dialog box will show me what categories the template will deploy, along with the fields, elements, and views that come with each of those. I can see that the template brought in 2 categories under the Categories section, and the category under the Models section called Furniture Sync from Revit. That one is waiting for me to publish a Revit model to my project. It contains fields that help me set up connections between layer elements and Revit objects. Let's take a look at the 2 categories under my Categories section. I can see that I have a Product Specs category and a Company Directory category. The Product Specs one contains 12 elements along with views that allow me to experience those in different ways and also help me with the management of my project. The elements and the fields are set up by the Layer team in a way that can act as inspiration for my own product specs. By clicking on the armless lounge chair, I can see the sequence of the fields that describe it. I can completely customize that to reflect my own product spec. I can change its name, I can clear out the existing photos, and upload my own. I can also change its cost. Here's a select input field to track the status of my product specs. If I want to alter it, I can click Edit Field and change its options. If I see a field that I have no use for, I can simply delete it. I can also change the sequence of the fields by clicking Edit Fields and then reorder them to my preference. I can always add a new field that helps me gather information about my product spec by clicking the plus button to add field. I can keep updating the rest of the product specs from the template, or I can delete them and make new furniture elements so the fields are empty for me to complete. The Company Directory category that comes with the template allows me to track the companies that I'm working with throughout this project. As earlier, I can edit the elements and fields as needed to better reflect the information for them. The reason these companies are their own category is because they are shared amongst different product specs. That means that one installer from my company directory can be the company that installs multiple furniture in my project. The template has already created a connection for you using the related element field. We will talk about the related element field and other advanced concepts in a video of a different series. To briefly showcase this, I will navigate to one of my product specs, and under the field manufacturer, I can see that I'm able to pick one of the companies from my company directory. If I need to pick multiple entries, I can edit the field and choose Select Multiple. Now that we covered the FFNE template, let's see how I can combine templates to help me with other tasks. Whenever I want to add a new template to my project, I can always do that from the plus button next to my categories section. I will see the same dialog box as when I was starting a new project. In this example, I will apply the meeting minutes template that will help me document my notes from the meetings with my clients. I'm happy with how this project is set up, and now I want to export that project as a template for future use. To do that, I will click on the gear icon next to my project's name and will select Create Template from Project. I can choose an icon and a color for it. I will also give it a name that will help identify the template in the future. The dialog box allows me to select the categories that I want my template to contain. Below the name of the category, I can see how many fields and views it will grab from my project for each category. I'm also given the ability to transfer elements along with the fields and views. For example, if I want to transfer the furniture that I created as well as the companies throughout this project, I can check Include Elements in Data on the right. The dialog box about dependencies gives me a warning that I have connections in my categories. I will click Continue to view the summary of my template and confirm its details. Once the template is created, I can now access it from a couple of places. I can click on the Templates tab on my dashboard, where I can view the template and also edit it as I need to. Here, I can add any new items that I want my template to contain in order to transfer them to a new or existing project. Also, when creating a project, I can navigate to the Company tab and select my newly created template to start a new project. Lastly, as we saw earlier, I can also use it within an existing project by clicking the plus button next to my category section, navigating to the Company tab, and selecting it. We now covered how layer templates can be used as an inspiration to a new project. We also explored how to create our own templates that can help us transfer information between different projects.